Incrementing and decrementing document field values in Firestore can be tricky because multiple users may update the same field simultaneously, leading to race conditions and data inconsistencies. Implementing them correctly in a SwiftUI project can also be tricky. In this video, I'll walk you through the process step by step, ensuring your updates are effective, reliable, and fully integrated into your SwiftUI apps. Also, check out the link in the description for super sale all of my products bundled into one, and also SwiftUI Camp. Now, today we are going to increment and decrement some values in a SwiftUI project with Firestore database inside the document. So, hear this. What if you have a like counter basically on your document? So whenever you have, let's say we have a post, and whenever you hit the post on the like, I hit the like, everybody else hits the like, and basically if you just want to do it like so, fetch the number from the server, incrementing it on the client, and then writing it back, there will be data races. So maybe most probably if you are doing this simultaneously, data will be lost. So there's a better way of doing this, incrementing and decrementing field values. That is what we are going to implement today, and we are going to use our project, our previous project. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for the full playlist. In the previous project, we implemented added Firestore collection for easy use. This is my GitHub repository. Again, take a look at the previous episodes of how to add that. And we are currently in the profile view. Now, in the profile view, we have our profiles collection, and then we just grab our profile, basically. So what I want to do is just have a kind of a stepper right over here after, before or below the text. And if I tap the plus button, it should increment the follower count. And if I add if I tap on the minus, it should decrement it. And all I did here, currently, let me just show it to you. I'm on the increment branch of the Firebase sign-in with Apple demo on a GitHub. Okay, so increment followers, decrement followers. Both of them are asynchronous flowing functions, so that's why I added this task and this catch. Attention iOS developers who code in SwiftUI. I'm running a super sale where you can get all my products bundled together at an incredible 91% discount. This includes SwiftUI Camp, a 4-week live bootcamp on Zoom designed to help you become an expert SwiftUI developer. The total value is $2,280, but for a limited time, you can get it all for just $199. SwiftUI Camp starts on March the 3rd, right after the sale ends, so don't miss this chance to level up your skills. Get the deal now, the link is in the description. So first of all, what I want to add is a state variable that will be binded to this stepper. Okay, so at state, private var, and that is loading, but followers count, and it should be an int value equals 0. So that would be our initial value. Okay, so now right over here below the text, I just want to add a new stepper. So let's just add our stepper right over here. I'm going to use the one with on increment and decrement with a label. Okay, there we go. The label, let's just have a text of followers. There we go. And then followers count. Well, we should just change that to a capital C. And on the increment, increment followers count, and on decrement, decrement followers count. So this is our basic stepper. It's really, really simple. And now let's just increment the followers count and decrement the followers count. Now, what I'm going to do currently on the profile, I don't have basically anything for the followers count. So we are actually going to create a followers count. Let's just add var followers count. of type string. And actually, this is not a good place to add it because these are required ones by the Firestorable. Just scroll down and add it right over here. So I'm going to copy it out and create our custom initializer, firewalls count, string value. Oh, not string value, sorry, int value. And that will be of type 0 and then self dot followers count equals followers count. That's great. And then another case on the coding keys. And then let's duplicate this. Followers count, it is of type int value for followers count, and default should be 0. And then on the encode, again, duplicating followers count, followers count. Okay. And that should be it. That's really everything that we need to add to our profile to just have a followers count. Now, currently, I don't have anything on the followers count. On the profiles, let's just take a look at it. I just have a user ID. But once I increment or decrement, it will be created right over here. You will see that in just a second. So let's go back to our profile view and let's see our increment right over here. So we are going to use our profiles collection. So try await profiles collection dot increment. And you can see that we have this field for ID. You can also have a by. I'm just going to go and increment it by 1. Default value for the by is 1. And there is also for the document if you are having a document. I'm just going to go with an ID. So increment field. What is the field name? Well, I'm going to copy it out so I make sure that I don't have any typos right over here. So increment field. And what is this for ID? Well, the ID is basically the document ID, which I can grab from right over here, from the fetch profile. I already have it. User ID, auth.auth, current user UID. So I want the current user's UID. So then I just go user ID. And the same goes for decrement. So I'm just going to copy it out. And instead of increment, I'm just going to go and use the decrement followers count for ID, user ID. So finally, let's build and run and see how all of this works. Again, this is really nice because it's going to do the increment, decrement part on the server. So there are not going to be any data races. So let's click on plus right over here. And we are not updating, but that's okay. We are going to fix that soon. Let's just double check on Safari. And as you can see, we have followers count 1. Really nice. So let's check this out. Let's just scroll up. We have followers count. Oh, we should use the profiles dot follower count. And actually, we don't need this followers count state variable. Let's build and run again, and let's see it in action. So now we should basically fetch that 1 follower, the count on that one. There we go, followers 1. Let's increment, and it did not increment it. Now, why is that? Let's just double check on the server. There we go, we have 2. So what gives? Well, actually, we need to fetch the profile again because we are unwrapping it from the query document. Again, take a look at the previous episodes. The link for the whole playlist on all of Firestore collection and also sign in with Apple is in the description. So basically, let's just go down and you see we already have this fetch profile function. So we want to add it after we increment and also after we decrement. Let's build it run. Finally, it should all work as expected. So let's see. Currently, we should have 2. There we go, 2 followers. Let's increment. And we have 3 right over here. Let's take a look at our database. Indeed, and we have 3. Let's go back to our simulator and let's maybe decrement 2. Let's double check. There we go, we have 2. And yeah, let me just move this so you can actually see it live of how I'm doing this. Plus, plus, there we go, it's counting up. Minus, minus. Again, the good thing here is that it's incrementing on the server. So whenever it hits the server, it's just going to do it. So there are not going to be any data erase conditions. And if you did like these types of videos, go ahead and check out my super sale. The link is down in the description.